had a friend like me. Yes, sir, we pride ourselves on service. You're the boss, the king, the Shah. Say what you wish is your stew dish. How about a little more baklava? Have some of Colin Bay and try all of Colin B. Well, I'm in the mood to help you, dude. You ain't never had a friend like me. Whoa-ho! Or now. Friends do this, can your friends do that, can your friends pull this from the little hat? Can your friends go boop? Well, look at here. Can your friends go abracadabra, let it rip, and then make the sucker disappear? So don't you sit there like dog bunny out of a bunch of hands on your midday prayers. You got the bona fide certified, you got genie for a charge to pass. You got a powerful urge to help you out, so what you wish, I really want to know. You got a list that's 3 miles long, no doubt, and all you gotta do is run like so. I know, Mr. Aladdin, sir, have a wish or two or three. But I'm on the job, you big name Bob. You ain't never had a friend, never had a friend. You ain't never had a friend, never had a friend. You ain't never had a friend like me. Yada bow, wow, yada bow. You ain't never had a friend like me.
Welcome to the Fat Cat Swinger Show.
The show where you go behind the bandstands.
And hang with the cats. Tune in for the stories.
And stay for the mayhem.
You might even spot some catching again.
With your hosts, Marco Palo.
And Mark Kapitsky. This week on the Fat Cat Swinger Show.
Singer, teacher, and cat whisperer, Nicole Kubitz. And the divine, delightful, and lovely Amanda Castro. Join in the fun, comment, and enter the giveaway.
Fasten your seatbelts, because here we go!
Hello there, sir.
We are back on another Wednesday night. How are you doing, Mark?
I'm doing well. I'm doing well. Better to be better now that I can see you. And it's going to be great to see Mr. Depps as well. But you've had a busy week, haven't you?
Oh, yeah. I've been out on the road with Mr. Louis Prima Jr. We got to hit some roads. We went to New Orleans, New York City, New Jersey, and had a good number of shows out there. And boy, I tell you, it was a lot of fun. And we just got – I just flew in yesterday. And
back to New York.
Upstate New York here. Yeah. And now I just get a little bit to rest, and then I'll be back in California next week.
Oh my goodness! Well, I hope you get some rest, well deserved rest after you know, making great music for all those people in all those different places. My goodness, so
yeah, how's your week been?
It's been good. It's been good. I've been working on some projects sort of in the background and getting a lot of stuff done, but it's been a good week. Not really performing this last week, but will this weekend. I'm doing a couple going to a few retirement centers and sort of doing the crooner thing and bringing some joy to those people.
I love it. Yeah. Very cool. Cool. Well, hey, you know what? We got two lovely guests, and I think we shouldn't hesitate to bring them on any longer. What do you say?
That's a great idea.
All right, let's bring on our first guest, Mr. Depps.
Roll that tape.
Be quite continental, but diamonds are a girl's best friend. A kiss may be grand, but it won't pay the rental on your humble flat or help you at the automat. Men grow cold as girls grow old, and we all lose our charms in the end. But square cut or pear shape, these rocks don't lose their shape. Best friend.
Ladies and gentlemen, how about it? Amanda Castro.
How are you guys? Thank you for having me on. So
absolutely. It's our pleasure. Thank you so much for making the time. And oh my goodness, I love that diamonds are a girl's best friend video. I think it just encapsulates the sort of glamour that you bring to all these songs. And you just have the whole thing, like even the bedazzled mic. I just love it.
I know that took me 10 hours to bedazzle. I did it myself.
I'll bedazzle anything.
Very nice.
That's the best when you can do that on your own, you know, because there's nothing, no other one like it. You made it yourself. And one of a
exactly.
kind. So cool. Well, Amanda, thank you so much for being here today. I know some of our friends who have been watching part from season one might recognize it, but we got some friends here from season two and maybe some new folks that'll be seeing this later that would get to know you. So we would like to tell them all about you. You've got your band and the Amanda Castro Band, and you do quite a number of songs, and the style that you mixes, you know, vintage jazz, New Orleans, but you do that amongst old music and new music as well.
Yeah, we do. You know, I love a mix of music, songs from the 20s. We have some things from 1912, 1918. But you know, who doesn't love Cher and George Michael, you know? So we have to jazz it up just to fit our style. So we love to take pop songs and jazz them up, and we'll bring the party with a little New Orleans, a little Latin as well, you know? So we're a very eclectic group. Yeah.
Yeah. And you've also, you worked with a variety of people too. So you've bring in some duets, you've done some duets. And I remember there's are they brothers that you've performed with?
Yes. The Kalama brothers.
Yes, the Kalama brothers.
They're so sweet, so talented. It's always such a pleasure to work with them. And they're amazing. If you haven't heard them, please go check them out. The Kalama brothers.
We might have to look them up and see if we can get them as guests on the show.
Yes.
All right.
That would be great. Yeah, they would be awesome. They're so fun, so nice.
Yeah, and you've also worked with another good friend of ours, Mr. Douglas Rogiers.
Yes, Mr. Douglas. I love Douglas. He's such a fun person to work with, you know, and I feel like our personalities match and our voices, so it's always so great to work with him.
Yeah, yeah. Now, Mark, we have a little clip of that, don't we?
We do. We do have a clip of that. Mr. Dapps, I believe it's the friend of friend in me.
You got a friend in me, yeah.
Yeah, you got a friend in me. You can pull.
And as the years go by, our friendship will never die. You're gonna see it's our destiny. You got a friend in me. Yeah, you got a friend in me. You got a friend.
That's so awesome.
Yes, and Marco was in that one too.
That's right.
You know, so much has happened this last year. I forgot that I did it. But yeah, that was like, hey, I recognize that guy. Shorter mustache, but it worked.
Because you guys did that earlier on, right? In sort of the lockdown, is that right?
Yeah, I believe it's been, what a year. I think we did it in May or June. So somewhere right towards the beginning of lockdown.
Yeah. And that's just such a fun arrangement. That's one of the, and the presentation as well is one of the better big band versions. I watched it the other day and I was like, wow, this is great. Oh, what is that from? That's from the beginning. It's like you guys had it right from the start.
Mm-hmm. Oh, thank great. You. Yeah. Patrick Aranda does all of our arrangements and he does such a wonderful job. And Cranbox does all our video editing and Dan, our audio. So we have a great little team who we work with. Yeah. So.
And has that team been who's really helped you? Because you do a lot of music videos and wonderful quality too. Like I just
learned
that for many years you've been doing this and building it up and building your audience on YouTube. Tell us about how that started.
Yeah, you know, I love YouTube as a platform. I think it's a great way to reach people. And what we do is music, you know. So we wanted to try and put out a video every month. You know, and at first it was definitely a mission, you know. It's hard to come out with a video a month because, you know, there's the arrangement, getting the guys together and video editing and all that good stuff. But, you know, we kind of just got the hang of it. A lot of them are live, so we'll just do it in 1 to 2 or 3 takes and there we go and just put it out there. And then sometimes if we want to change it up, we pre-record the song and like we did with When I Get Low, I Get High. You know, we pre-recorded that. We had the fabulous LA Follies join us for that one. And it was a super fun project. But the team, it's the team. Tessa, Dan, Patrick, you know, the band members, I call them my musical family, you know. I feel so blessed to have them as part of this ACB journey.
Yes, mm-hmm. ACB. Could we get I think we also have a clip of When I Get Low, I Get High. I'd love
to see
that. Oh, cool.
Thank you.
Roll that tape.
Yeah.
My Fergusco landlord ain't cold. I'm not gonna holler, cause I still got a dollar. When I get low, I get high. Now my man walked out, now you know that ain't right. So you better watch out if I meet him tonight. When I get low, I get high. All this hard luck in this town has found me. Nobody knows the trouble all around me. I'm all alone with no one to pet me in my rocking chair. Ain't never gonna get me. When I get low, I get high.
Yeah.
Wow. Oh my gosh, we shot that right before the lockdown too.
Really?
We shot it at the end of February and 2 weeks later we went into the lockdown. So
That was
perfect
fun.
And
so many familiar faces, too. I see Lakshmi there.
Lakshmi.
And Sammy K on drums.
Sammy K. We love Sammy K. Yeah. Lakshmi.
And then what a wonderful horn section you got there. Who is it? Nate Kettner.
Nate Kettner. Yeah, Andrew Carney. Sean O'Kelly actually pre-recorded that. And then we have Jared on there too. Yeah, we love Sean.
Nice.
Yeah.
And what was it like to collaborate with the LA Follies? I mean,
I love working with them. We actually work with them a lot. We
oh,
do
really?
A lot of events together, a lot of Gatsby events. And, and they're just such a, I Colette and all the girls are fabulous. Yeah. I love working with them. So any chance I get to, it's exciting.
Now, I wanted to ask, you know, these videos are amazing. It just brings so much sort of joy and happiness to be able to be watching this last year over the last 15 months or so. But you had a live show, right? Just recently.
Yes.
What was it like to be back performing live? Instead
it was
of doing
so
videos?
Weird. It was so weird. You know, yeah. I've been kind of nervous about it, but, you know, we just went for it. You know, we were actually at Vibrato. It was a great night, you know, a lot. I haven't seen that many people in a long time in a room. Oh my gosh, my bird. Sorry, guys. I have a parrot.
So, I love it.
I'll start screaming. But it was wonderful, you know. It was so great to be back playing live music. Do you hear him?
Yeah. I think he wants some questions. So you mentioned before we went live that you have some animals. And you
kind of live on a farm, you said, right?
Yeah, you said a farm.
Yes. That's my Moluccan cockatoo, Arthur. He's 22 years old.
Wow.
He's saying hi, Arthur. That's my life, you guys.
Hi, Arthur.
Oh, hey, Arthur.
He's like, hey. He sees me.
How cute. And so you have a...
Ah! Oh, yeah. Sorry. Let me hide.
That's so cute.
It's a live
I
show.
Love it.
It's great. I love it.
But I think we actually have a couple photos of some of your pets that you have on the farm there.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, let's take a look at what we have here. Oh,
Walter and Stanley.
Hello.
Oh, <goodness.
laughs> Snuggling.
That's Charlie, my bearded dragon.
Charlie.
Oh, Charlie. Charlie bit me.
And that's Bonbon.
Oh,
dog.
I love the name Bonbon.
Oh yeah.
That's so cute.
Personality. Yeah.
I have to ask, because I see it in the comments here, but is it at all possible to see Arthur?
You know what? Yes. Let me see if he'll come. Let me try. I'll be right back, you guys.
All right. Okay.
And in the meantime, we'll tell all our friends here that, you know, if you're watching from home on a smart TV and you want to partake in the comments, check it out on your phone as well. And you can comment there while you watch on your smart TV. And also, if you would, if you haven't already, give this a share on social media so we could tell all our friends to come check out what else is going to happen, because we got some fun games going on tonight. And and what else do we have today that we might have forgotten to mention?
We're not going to do the giveaway quite yet.
Yes, so go ahead and save those hashtags for later. We're going to do those in a little moment, probably right during the game section, I think. Oh, here we go.
Oh, my. Arthur.
Hey, say hi, Arthur.
Hey, Arthur.
He's a little nervous, but that's Arthur.
Hi, Arthur.
Hi. Say hi, Papa. He's like, what's going on?
What's going on?
Hey there.
So that's my baby.
Yeah.
Arthur.
Thank you for letting us say hi.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'll be right back.
Bye, Arthur.
I feel like we need
We need a little... There you go. Good job, Marco. That crest. Oh my goodness. I think
I've got some hair competition right now.
Yeah.
I'm gonna rewind to this section of the show later and I'm gonna take some notes.
We could take some tips from Arthur.
So I know we've got you know, also one thing, we do have some upcoming Amanda, I think, does she have an upcoming show soon?
That's right. Amanda, you have an upcoming performance, isn't that right?
Yes, we actually have one that we just booked, so I haven't announced it yet. At Vibrato on August 7th, and then we'll also be at Campus Jacks on August 21st. Yeah, right. So two big shows coming up.
All right, in August. Yeah. Great. That's awesome. So I want to go back to the Arthur and the farm, if we could. Did you grow up on the farm?
Yeah, you know, pretty much. I mean, my family loves animals, you know, and that's always been my dream. I mean, we've had chickens. I had a house chicken, pretty much. She lived indoors.
Yeah.
Super sweet, you know. So any chance I get, I'll take all the animals, you know.
Yeah.
We have a duck outside. His name's Donnie. koi fish, turtles. I've raised pigeons, and they still live around the house, you know, so I love animals.
See, now, I got to ask, though, because there's a couple of your videos that I've seen online that look like they're in a, like in a barn. Is that your barn?
No. Okay, we were on location for the sunshine one. We're kind of like in a barn area. Yeah, we were on location. I wish. Oh. One day I'll have a huge, huge barn, but no.
Hey, gotcha. And you'll have a whole cast of characters to join in on your music videos. Yes.
Exactly.
Yeah. When is Arthur going to be in the next one? Because I think that's a request I'm going to make.
You know what? Yeah. Maybe. We'll see. He's feisty, you know? Oh. So sometimes he likes the camera. Sometimes he's like, nah, leave me alone. I don't feel like it. You know? So it just depends on his mood.
He's a diva. Okay.
He is. But he loves to sing. He dances like this. Yeah. You know,
oh my goodness,
he screams so loud. You can hear him four houses down. He's loud.
Wow. Sorry, Marco, were you going to say something?
No, go ahead.
No, but you had mentioned before the stream, kind of how you got your start with music. And usually that's a question we ask anyway, but why don't you tell us when you started with music and why?
You know, I was a softball player for 14 years, hardcore, travel ball, varsity softball, all throughout high school. The plan was to get a full ride scholarship, you know, but I ended up getting injured and I wasn't able to play anymore. My last catch was diving through the air and catching a line drive and then bam, you know, that was it. That was my softball career. So I needed something to do. I loved music. I never sang in my life before, but why not? So I just started singing and it worked out, thank goodness.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's pretty much how I started. I was a tomboy softball girl.
And now you bedazzle microphones and bandstands and
our bandstands too,
I love the bandstands, how they sparkle. It's awesome. Aww. That's, you know, I think that's one of those things you and Fat Cat, we all have that flashiness, you know, that we love to put out there, you know?
Yes, you know, we love the flashy, the sparkle, you know?
I think it just creates this ambiance and experience, like you're just here for something special. You're not just here to hear some music. There's something special is going to happen.
Exactly. It's an experience. It's a show, you know?
And yeah.
All those little things add to the experience.
Exactly.
Yeah.
You know, and I wanted to ask, so all of this, you've also found a bit of an opportunity and like a passion in the way that you connect people. Like, we love to connect people here with Fat Cat as well, but I noticed that you do too. And you started booking a lot of shows as well. And like even beyond your band, can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah. You know, I have a small little agency that I started pre-corona. Cause I love the business end of things. You know, I feel like that's where I really excel. That's my thing, you know? So I actually have two bands, you know, one's more for private events and then the ACB. And it's been great, you know, things are starting to slowly come back. So I'm excited to take that to the next level. Yeah, but it's fun. Booking shows is super fun.
Yeah, I hear you with the business side of it. That's been something that's definitely, it's been a forte of mine that I've kind of focused on. And typically I do that, but it's fun when you start to bring people together to do it and see like everyone rising up together too. It's pretty fun. Like all the opportunities that you get, you know?
Exactly. You know, and I feel, especially now more than ever, we have such an amazing musical family, you know, and I love how all of us, you know, we're all just connected, you know, and we all get along really well. And it's great. You know, that's what music's about, you know, being happy and enjoying each other's company and just a positive vibe. And that's what we're always looking for, unicorns, you know?
Yeah. I have to ask one question. Are you, I know that, you know, we both work at Disney quite a bit. Are you a fan of Disney movies?
I love Disney movies. Actually, but I love Disney as a whole. I don't really watch a lot of movies though. I'll watch them sometimes, but I don't know.
We're going to split, but are you familiar with some of the Disney movies?
Yes, I am. Okay. I am, definitely.
All right, I think so. The reason I ask is because I want to, I think, segue into our next little segment here and bring on our good friend, Mr. Daps, shall we?
Cool. Yeah.
Let's roll that tape. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Daps.
Hey, everybody.
Hey. Hey. Oh, my gosh, I'm scared.
I don't want to be that guy.
You want to be scared, all right? Get the adrenaline going. Mr. Daps is a very scary man.
Nothing to be scared about. Before we get into the game, did you guys want to share a hashtag?
We sure did.
Yes, actually, this will be a great time to do the hashtag. So we are going to do hashtag Amanda Castro Band, and you get to enter this three times within this segment. No more than three, please. And what we are going to do, you can spread them out if you'd like. And we are going to pick a winner after this game segment, and you are going to win some Amanda Castro Band merchandise. So, all right.
All right.
All right. Well, it is time for 5-second summaries. And that means that we are going to show one of you a movie, which you get to summarize in 5 seconds, which means the other two of you will have to hide your eyes for a second while I show what the movie is going to be. Okay. And then you will have 5 seconds to summarize what that movie is. And you cannot say the name of the movie, the title character, you know, the things that are obvious like that.
Okay.
Like,
can't make sounds.
I think you could probably make sounds, but for example, if it was the Little Mermaid, you wouldn't want to say a mermaid decides to go live on sea or out of the sea and run away from her father.
Okay.
Because that would just be, I think, a little bit too easy. Does that sound fair to everybody?
That's fair, but there's something that's unfair is that there's already shade in the comments about me. And so I'm just saying, we haven't even started yet.
Well,
I'm not happy.
I don't know what to tell you about that. Because this time,
those comments, these people out here.
This time it wasn't me.
But look what you've done.
I don't know if I've done it or it just organically grew out of the magic of the Fat Cat Swingers show.
It's fine. I'm gonna rock this game. We're good.
I think we should, ladies first. Sounds very fair to me. Does that sound good with you, Amanda?
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay, so Marco and Mark, would you please cover your eyes?
Oh, man.
And Amanda, I'm going to show you this movie.
Okay.
And you're going to have 5 seconds to describe it. And then you're going to hear a very odd noise that will let you know that your time is up. All right, Marco and Mark, you can now uncover your eyes.
All right.
And Amanda, are you ready?
As ready as I can be.
All right, go for it. And you'll see me count down with my hand too.
Okay, so sleeping kids. Oh, goodness, I'm drawing a blank. I'm going to give it away.
A Monsters, Inc.
That is incorrect,
it?
Mark.
Oh, no. did I even describe it right? I didn't even describe anything.
That's part of the game. So Mark is already negative 100 points, and
excuse
we have
me.
Barely started the game. Marco, would you like to guess?
Today. Oh, shoot.
Okay, sleeping kids.
And I did think I heard the word fly at the end. Did I hear that
yes.
at the end? Okay,
yeah.
That was...
Peter Pan.
Yes.
Yes. Marco for 100 points up.
Wow.
I'm sorry, Mark. Like,
I was terrible. Yeah. I'm sorry.
Amanda, come
no,
on.
You weren't. I'm no, you sorry. Weren't. You were great. All right. So I think, Marco, since you were the first winner of this, you get to go next. So Mark
right,
and Amanda,
right.
would you please cover your eyes?
Oh, no.
Oh, really? No. I thought this was an easy one.
I have not even seen this movie.
Oh, this could be fun.
Okay, all right. Okay, all right.
All right, are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, you can uncover your eyes, everybody.
Okay, my best thing I'm going to do is I'm going to tell you what the Disney is full of a lot of magic and...
Five. Ready?
Magic and... Yes.
Here we go. Five, four... Go ahead. Sorry,
I'm counting. Yeah. No, Disney is full of a lot of magical things. That magic, and what's another word for magic? I haven't seen this movie, so I'm sorry.
Fantasia? I don't know.
Not quite. No. But for what you got, that's not a bad guess. You want to guess, Mark?
No, I don't. Because I get negative points. I'm not guessing ever again. If I just don't guess, I'll probably win.
You know what? If it's a really good guess, you might get random points.
I have no idea. No, I'm not going to do it. Don't trick me into that. No, I'm not going to do it. I'm not guessing.
All right.
I have no idea. I really don't.
The movie was Enchanted.
I thought
that one would be good because they have the sequel coming out, and maybe that's in the public consciousness, but maybe not. All right, Mark.
And Cameron are going to have a movie night pretty soon.
We're going to have a movie night. I'm going to catch up on that one.
Yeah, we'll have to cook again. all right. Marco and Amanda, would you please cover your eyes? Right, and Mark, right. You're in for some fun.
Okay.
That's a fun one, right? I feel like that's a fun one.
Yeah. I can't think of anything, so let's just do it. Okay, I'm ready.
Okay, Ari, you can uncover your eyes, everybody.
All right.
And you can start, Mark.
All right, so he's trying to build a big house on top of a tiny little house. There's a llama.
Amanda.
Do you have a guess, Amanda?
He's building a house on a... And there's a llama, mm-hmm. You said? A llama? Yeah. Oh, gosh, I can't remember. But I see it in my mind.
You got it.
Oh, no! What is it? I can't
Marco,
remember.
Would you help us?
Is it The Emperor's New Groove?
That is correct, sir. Oh, yes. Marco is on a roll with now 250 points total. Very well done, sir. All right, Amanda, it is back to you. I think this one might be... Actually, this doesn't help you that it's easier because it helps them. But gentlemen, would you please cover your eyes?
Oh, okay.
Good one? Okay. All right, great. Gentlemen, you can uncover your eyes.
All right.
And whenever you'd like, Amanda.
Okay, so a father is trying to find his son.
Finding Nemo!
You were correct, sir. We didn't even have time to get to the... That was very, very well done. Mm-hmm. I think that means you get to go next. That sound fair? Yeah.
Yay. And I think I'm positive points now.
Right? Yeah, you are. You're at like 100 points now.
All right.
I decided since Amanda has been describing so well, she gets an extra 200 points.
Oh, yay.
So it's Marco 250, Amanda 200, and Mark, you're at 100. Oh. All right. If Marco and Amanda would please cover their eyes.
Okay.
All right. You can uncover your eyes. And Mark, whenever you're ready.
Opening song is L is for the way you... And there's twins, and they're trying to get them back together, and it's...
Okay, I think I'm willing to take a guess, but Amanda, you got anything?
I can't... No. I don't know. It's terrible. I'm sorry.
Marco.
Parent Trap.
You are correct, sir.
Yay! Not going to lie, I just watched this like within the last week or two.
Which version did you watch, though?
I watched the one with Lindsay Lohan.
Okay, the newer version.
Yeah.
I think the version you were talking about, Mark, is the original. Is that correct?
No, but it does.
No, it is the new one?
Yeah, it has.
It does have Nat King Cole. Yeah.
Yeah. Awesome. All right, Marco, you get the last one.
Oh, all right. Hope it's a good one.
Amanda and Mark, would you please cover your eyes?
All right. For the big... Oh, you know... okay. All right.
You haven't seen that one either?
Well, I... only partially saw it because I think I was tired on an airplane and I fell asleep.
Okay, but well, you'll be fine. I can. All right, you can uncover your eyes.
I could do soundtracks, right? Because Melanie did soundtracks last time.
You can do whatever you want.
All right,
all
right, go ahead.
Are you ready? When the crypt doors creak and the tombstones quake, ding, dum, dum, da, da, ding, ding, dum, happy haunts materialize and begin to...
I mean,
Amanda, do you know this one? You're smiling like you might.
No.
I know, okay. Right, but I don't. That's a movie?
What? It's yeah, movie. That's what I was thinking.
What do you think it is? Just say it. Either of you is fine.
And these are Disney movies, right?
It's a Disney movie.
Sometimes they make movies.
Nightmare Before Christmas? No.
Not quite. Half the year. So half the year.
I have no idea.
Half of the year it is that.
Yes, half the year. Mark, do you have a guess?
No, I didn't know that there was a... I don't know.
What do you think it is?
I that was going to be my guess, but it's not Disney. So it's like... movie. Is it actually in the movie, that song?
In the background, I believe, actually.
And where does that song come from?
Our friends. And I believe in the movie, the Dapper Dans are singing it.
Mm. What?
I thought that was a clue.
I don't know. I'm just
Marco, save them.
Bed Knobs and Broomsticks. No. I don't know.
The Haunted Mansion, my friends.
Is that a movie?
It is a movie.
Eddie Murphy.
Oh my gosh, I remember. I never saw it, but
it came out after, I believe, Pirates of the Caribbean, and it didn't have quite the same culture effect.
Okay, yeah. Gotcha.
It's one of those ones to watch really late at night when you're a little bit loopy.
Or when you're going to fall asleep on an airplane.
Or falling asleep on an airplane.
Oh, okay, gotcha. All right, well, you tried. Well done.
Very well done, everybody. Marco, I have to give it to you tonight, though. You were a scholar for Disney movies.
Yeah.
Mark, for Bed Knobs and Broomsticks, I have to demote you 1,000, maybe 100,000 points, because that I don't even know where that came from. Nightmare Before Christmas, you get an extra 100 points for, because half of the year you're correct.
I like that movie. I thought it'd be cool. I did like a throwback, you know, like,
you
know. I don't know.
My uncle's in that movie for just a second. He's
really
he's playing a saxophone in the band.
Soldiers of the Old Home Guard.
I don't know. I think it's like at a fair or something.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Yeah. Sorry. I should find out better details before
you
I start
should point him out. The Queen of the Movie Night
on the internet. It's great.
Clearly, we all have to have a movie night again at some one of these.
Yeah, one or two, huh?
And then we'll play it again.
Yeah.
There you go.
Well,
but
guys,
in the meantime,
you bet. Yeah,
thank you, and Amanda, thank you so much for playing along with us as well. I think it's time to do our giveaway and check out those comments for the hashtags.
Yeah.
Cool.
So if you would scroll in there and
scroll.
So we got some. There we go. Drum roll and.
Addie Kate.
Oh, bravo!
Woo! Congratulations, Addie Kate.
Hey. Addie Kate, if I'm not mistaken, I think she might be downstairs watching. This is Cameron and her nieces are downstairs watching.
Oh, really?
In the farmhouse. Amazing. So, congratulations, Addie. You actually get a little shirt. And what are we doing? A shirt and a CD or?
Yeah, shirt and CD. Yeah.
Shirt and CD. Awesome.
Yeah.
Cool.
Nice. Cool. Yay. Congratulations.
How cool. Well, Amanda, I hope you had fun with us today. And thank you for coming back on season two.
Yes. Thank you guys so much for having me. It was such a blast. You guys are doing amazing work and putting positive energy and love out to the universe. So I love it, you guys.
That's what it's all about. Spreading some smiles and making folks happy while we're at home, waiting for all our shows to come back. Because, you know, even though they're coming back slowly, you know?
Yeah.
Well, we'll be here on Wednesdays. And gosh, Amanda, thank you so much. Say hello to Pat and all the pets and everybody everybody and the band, anyone that you see again.
Yes.
Your shows again. One more time. Let's talk about those before we go. They are on the
Is it July 20th? No.
We have August 21st. August 7th, Vibrato, and then August 21st, Campus Jacks.
All right, there it is. We'll make sure to have those in the description of the YouTube below.
Oh, thank you.
So we can get friends to your show as well. But Amanda, thank you so much. Everybody, Amanda Castro.
Thank you for having me, guys.
Bye. Bye, Arthur.
Bye. Oh, man, that was fun. But, boy, we got to brush up on some movies, don't we?
Yes, we do. We do. You'd think that we would have done that this last year, but being at home all the time. But
I got to admit, I probably saw more movies than I've seen in more than half of my life this last year. So
okay, good, good. Okay, well, I got to catch up then.
Yeah.
The ticket link for Amanda's show is in the description. We'll put up the other one as well for the Vibrato. But our show's not done, right?
It's not done. We got another guest that we're going to bring on, ladies and gentlemen. So, Mr. Daps, roll that tape.
A distant memory flashes over me. Even though you're gone, I feel you deep inside.
Welcome, everybody, Nicole Kubis.
Hey. Hello, hello, welcome.
Hello, hi, guys.
Hello.
Hello.
Back to season two. This time, Mark and I both get to be here because last season it was Mark and you together on the show.
I know.
So I'm excited to get a chance to meet you and chat with you tonight, too.
I know. This will be good. But I got to tell you off the bat, I don't have a parrot. So if that's a deal breaker, then I'm out. Yeah.
Cats.
I do have cats. Not here, but I do have cats. Right. Yeah.
Yes, she does. Here's a little picture of.
Oh,
my gosh. Look at them.
How pretty.
What are their names?
Stormy's the gray one, and then the brown tabby with the white feet. That's Sammy. So,
oh my goodness,
Sammy.
Yeah,
oh, man. Well, before we go any further, happy belated birthday!
Thank you.
Yeah, and people in the comments, please wish Nicole a happy birthday.
Thanks.
And so, oh my goodness, thanks so much for making time in your birthday week, your birthday month.
Yeah, it's it's good. I've recovered since then, so we're good.
Yeah.
Partying. Good. It was fun. It was a lot of fun.
Good. Yeah. Good.
Aw, awesome.
Yeah.
Fun. So I'd like to know. So there's that clip in the beginning we saw was for Eclipse, and this is a newer group that you're doing, right?
Yeah. Technically, that clip, well, the girls and I, my two best friends, we do everything together. So it's just kind of a change of costume and a change of music, and we're a new group. But we kind of decided that was going to be our, you know, our pet project. That's kind of been a dream of ours. We actually met in high school singing classic rock music and then kind of fell into the swing thing. And that was really fun because at the time it was different. But then we did the swing thing so long, we were like, wait, now we want to go back and sing the other stuff too. So that was kind of a fun project that kind of came on over the quarantine. And so, yeah, it's been a lot of fun.
Cool.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, yeah. And the Eclipse is pretty new, right? It's like a year old. Well, to have the name, the Eclipse, you guys have been doing that music for a while, but.
Yeah. Yeah. We just put a name to it, and I'm actually playing guitar in the group. So that's kind of fun. It's different. So yeah, that's kind of our first attempt at trying it, and we love it. It's been fun.
Yeah, and what's sort of the significance of the name, if we can ask at all? Or
Well, we could not think of anything for the life of us, because we were trying to think of it because we've been the Swing Kittens for, actually, this is our 10th year. Next month will be our 10th year as the Swing Kittens. So we were like, well, shoot, what do we do? So we love, like, everything to do with space and the moon and the stars and stuff. So we decided that eclipse is when the sun, the earth, and the moon are all aligned. And since we're best friends and we're always aligned, that's where we got the name. And then we put the three at the end because there's three of us and we thought it was cool. So that's it.
That is really cool. I like that.
Okay, yeah. Good. I'm glad you guys like
it. Yeah. And and this is the sort of logo for it, right? Yeah.
Yep. That's our logo.
I like it. Thanks. And you know, I think it'd be nice to show, I know that this clip we're going to show is when you guys were doing the Swing Kittens at Campus Jack's, I think cool. It was Thanksgiving, but I believe it's a little bit of a sample of some of the stuff that you guys do together beyond Toto. So Mr. Daps, can we pull up the clip of Signed, Sealed, Delivered? Oh man. Go ahead, Marco.
I was gonna say, I have to ask now, because the name Kubis is no strange name to me. I've heard that name quite a bit. So you come from a very musical family, am I correct in saying that?
I do. I had no choice.
You had no choice.
I was stuck here.
I feel like that's a special gift to be born in a band and be able to perform with such great musicians all the time.
Yeah, and I'm realizing more as I get older, like how cool it is. You know, like when I'm young, I'm just like, whatever, this is my life. You don't really think about it. And then as I'm getting older and like, you know, starting to meet people and they're like, that's really interesting. And I'm like, oh, I guess it kind of is. It's cool. Like, and to kind of have all these guys as like my uncles, they've been, you know, everybody in my dad's big band has watched me literally since I was born. So it's just a fun relationship, and it's cool to just, I mean, make music with just the best musicians ever. So
really,
it's just so fun. Yeah.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I do want to go back to that clip, because that was in November of last year. And what was it like to have been sort of in intense lockdown and then do an actual show?
That was kind of right still in the middle. That was like, I mean,
that was the teaser opening. It was like, things are about to open. Yes.
Yeah. And so it was very like, like, you know, we were there and it was like, we didn't even know if anyone was going to come, because it was so like, it was around the holidays, and that's when things started to like creep up again. And we were like, this feels like we shouldn't be doing it. But of course we were excited to be doing it. So it was, there's a level of like uncertainty that went along with that show. But then when we started performing, it was like, oh, this is fun, you know? Mm-hmm. And we had a great band that night. We had Alex Isles playing trombone. We had Jamie Tate on drums. We had Mike Campagna playing trumpet. It was so fun. And it was just, felt good for sure. So,
yeah.
It's nothing quite like performing live, I tell you, like this.
I know.
Anything, even the rehearsals don't match that energy that you put out when you're on stage performing live, because you get that whole vibe from the audience and just being there, and it's just in the actual moment. Like, this is keeps in our memories, and here we go.
Yeah, and I feel like more than ever, like, that connection with the audience or even just being around your bandmates is just, like, you just want to, like, absorb all that positive energy, because you're like, oh, I've missed it so much. Like, please don't leave me, you know? It's like, it's just so fun. You realize how valuable that is when you don't have it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I'm going to pick up a question from our audience over here. We got a question here that, who is your singing inspiration?
Ironically enough, Stevie Wonder. Stevie Wonder, I love everything he does. I think he is just so tasteful and fantastic. I've recently been really enjoying Mel Torme. I think wow. You know, I mean, I've always like known who he was, but like to really listen and kind of notice all the like finite details of his mastery of singing. He's just fantastic. And then in the pop world, Stevie Wonder, but actually there's a singer that I love. She's an underground indie artist. So if you know who she is, you know, and if you don't, you really don't. But her name is Brandi Carlile.
Yes! I love Brandi Carlile.
She's like a freak of nature. I don't know how she sings the way she does. I've seen her live 3 times. She never misses a note. And I think she's just so cool and unique. So yeah, it kind of spans all kinds of areas. So good question. That was
fun. Thank you. And I want to ask, because I'm sure we have some viewers who maybe aren't familiar with the Swing Kittens. So can you just, who are the Swing Kittens? How did that get started? I've known you guys forever, but
yes,
our viewers might not.
Yes, we've known you in the beginning and we were on the road and we were all in the same van together going to the first gig in Thailand. And we went,
that's right.
Who are you? What do you do? And you're like, I sing. And we're like, what? Amazing. And then we were friends ever since.
Yeah. Was that on Glenn Miller or was that something else?
Yeah.
Yeah, the touring.
Yeah, we all just sort of met in the van.
Yeah,
yeah. I didn't think we had met on the plane or anything. It was just like, all right, now we're in this country, and where are we going? Yeah.
Anyway. Who are these people? Yeah. But sorry. Go ahead.
Swing Kittens came out of that, or were they already a thing?
We were a thing. We started right out of high school. In fact, Nicole and I are the two of the founding members. We had the four other members before we have Kaylee, who we've had for the past 10 years. But we met in high school, and then I was singing with a band, a local band. And then the band leader had suggested we do like an Andrew Sisters kind of thing for some of the gigs. And so I was like, okay. So I asked my friend Nicole, and then she was down. And then we had another member, then we had another member, then we had another member. And then we got Kaylee, who was younger. In fact, she was 17 when she joined. And so we just started doing gigs. We started recording a little bit. And then we got the phone call to do the Glenn Miller thing. We got a recommendation who said, I think he even told the band leader, he said, they're young, but they'll be fine. And we thought it was a joke when we got the email. We thought it was like a scam or something really sketchy. Was like, would you like to join us for a 10-day tour of Thailand and the Philippines? And we were like, is this legit? Like, this is not right.
No, I thought it was for like a cruise line.
Really?
Scam thing. It was like, how much is it going to cost? And you
know. Yeah. So, yeah. And then, and the rest was history. That was it. And we've been, yeah, like I said, it's been 10 years of a lot of fun times and crazy times. So that's how we got started. We were just, I think we were 18. Yeah.
Yeah, but you had mentioned, you know, you Nicole and Kaylee have been together for 10 years. I mean, what is it like to get to be performing and touring with your best friends? I mean,
it's the best. And honestly, if it was anybody else, we would have not stayed together, I think. I know. I mean, you get 3 girls together and we've shared many a hotel room, you know, 3 of us to 1 tiny little room, you know, Mark, you know,
yes, I do. Not cool.
And with anybody else that could have been totally horrible, but with us, it's just the perfect balance. We're all different. We all respect each other where we are. We know we need space. We know what we need. So, it's just been honestly the best. It's been a dream. I can't even explain it. And sometimes I sit and I go, what the heck? That's been really cool. So yeah. And I live with my best friend actually. And Kaylee, we see her all the time. So it's like, we hang out, we sing. It's
awesome.
Yeah.
Best of all worlds. You combine your best friends and your passion for music
and
you're making out there happening and traveling and everything. That's amazing.
Yeah.
I have to ask, I don't know, but I should have asked beforehand before we went live, but we don't happen to have a clip of you guys singing together or anything like that, do we?
Ooh.
Oh, us, me and the kittens?
Yeah.
Yes, it's not a very good quality one, but...
But we have something. I think
I have something. I think I put in over our track, so we'll talk about the track in a second, but
oh, cool.
Mr. Dapps, would you mind pulling up South Rampart?
Yes.
Clip.
Fast or slow, but on
Nice.
Oh, man. That was my favorite one to do with you guys. It was so much fun.
And we totally snuck that in the show, too. That was not related to Glenn Miller. And we just said, can we please do the song? And the band leader was like, okay.
But the crowd loved it.
I know.
They, I know. Yeah. Oh,
you so caught bad. The spirit of what was happening in that time. And that counts a lot of times.
That's
you know?
True. That's true. That's true. It was so fun. Oh, my gosh.
I love yeah. that. Well, Mark, is there anything you want to highlight before we go into our next segment?
Well, I just want to also mention, though, Nicole, you're a full-time teacher, right? And you're busy even over here over the summer doing something special.
Yeah, and in fact, I got done with that and came here and got myself together and for this, but I am teaching right now a pop music summer camp. With a colleague and a friend of mine, and we're teaching all the students guitar. We're working on songwriting, vocals, and so it's just kind of a fun, what do you call it, like a buffet of things for them to learn. And so that's what I'm doing over the summer, but during the school year, I'm teaching voice and guitar, and I'm a vocal director for a popular music program at a high school. So I stay busy.
Nice.
Yes. Yeah, and then always on these tours, too, you were staying busy because – these arrangements for the vocal arrangements.
Right. Right.
You were right.
So yeah, some of them, the girls and I usually can pick out kind of, if we're going to copy, you know, an Andrew Sisters song, we just kind of know, we don't even have to talk about it. We're telepathic at this point, kind of who's right. going to take what, but yeah, if we're going to do something new or unique, that's kind of my pride and joy is to work on making interesting or different vocal things. So Mark's been a part of that too.
So. I like that. You know, speaking of interesting and unique vocal things, I have a feeling we need to call on Mr. Daps right now.
Let's
call, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Daps.
All right.
You know, Marco, you're exactly right. We have fun coming up with these games, and tonight might be one of my new favorites. Uh-oh. And, Marco and Mark and I were talking earlier and they threw out some ideas. And so I, of course, went and did my own thing. And so this this is going to be, we're going to call it the imitation game. Is that a good name for it, guys? This is the imitation game. And what is going to happen is I am going to play a sound that hopefully you can hear. And then each of you will get a chance to do your imitation at what any level you would like. You can do just vocal. That's fine. That'll get you some points. If you were to move in and add some, hand gestures or acting along with it, might get you more points. You never know. You know, the more you make me laugh, generally the more points you get. So we will see how this goes. Okay. And are you three ready?
Ready.
Sure.
I do have one question for you, Nicole. Since you are our guest, normally I would go ladies first, but if you prefer...
Mark first.
Oh, she knows how this show goes.
Okay, fine. Let's do it.
All right. Okay, this is fun. All right, so we are going to start with this one, and I hope you can hear this. Not exactly what we talked about earlier, but I think it will be fun. So, Mark, would you give us your best Super Mario Brothers jump sound? Now, did you just want to do one, or did you want to really sell this?
I don't know.
Could you do it?
I hope somebody's recording that.
I gotta start lower.
Oh, you wanna do another one? Okay. Beautiful.
I don't think I nailed it. I don't think
I did. That wasn't nailing it. Okay, so I guess since you didn't nail it, that's 75 points.
Okay, I
was actually very impressed and was gonna give you 100, but you said you didn't nail it, so.
Man, I can get a break with you.
Nicole, who would you like to see go next? Same sound effect.
Same sound effect.
What?
All right. All three of you get to do this.
I should have had Mark go last. That's too good. I can't follow. I just messed up. Oh, no. No. I can't. Okay. We're all doing the same sound effect?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Oh, gosh. Okay. I'll go next. All
yours.
We were just going.
Easy 75 points.
Thank you. All right.
That's Marco. It.
All right.
I'm going to give you 50 points because that was very good vocally. And I'm actually giving Mark an extra 25 points because he jumped so high three times.
I've been working on that. Got to get my fat cat jumps back.
And we don't have a Fat Cat Swinger Show historian, but this might be one of the first times you've started the game in the lead.
Hey.
So congratulations on that as well.
Bravo.
All right. Are we ready for the next one? I think, Nicole, you get to go first this time.
Okay.
This is one of my favorites from one of my favorite shows. So this is the roughest because I had to pull it from the show, but enjoy. So that would be Beaker from the Muppets.
Oh my God.
And I pulled that from Muppet Vision 3D, which is one of my favorite Disney attractions of all time. Okay. So would you do your best Beaker, please?
Yeah.
Good luck, guys. That's 100 points.
I love Beaker.
Me too. Thank you very much. That was, I don't know if they can beat that. You might get bonus points for this. And it looks like Mark is losing his internet for a second. Oh, there we go. Wait. Marco, how about you go next?
All right. I'm trying to find any nearby props, but I'm pretty sure Beaker is orange, so I'm going to go.
There you go. That is very well done, too. 100 points for you also.
Yay.
All right, Mark, no pressure.
No pressure. Okay. All right.
What's gonna happen here?
I don't know. Very well done, sir. Oh. I think we just figured out who Mark would be as a Muppet. I'm gonna give you 125 points, Mark.
Wow. All right, Mark's making a comeback.
You were doing very well. All right, we're going to go Disney now. Okay. And I think everybody should know this one. It's been done a million times. Your best Goofy Wilhelm scream, please. And Marco, you get to start this time.
Okay. Okay. All right, well.
Don't turn on your windows or anything, Marco. I mean,
oh, no.
I win.
Gosh, Max, I just don't know. I don't want to get kicked all the way out here. Yeah! Oh. How's that? Did that work?
100 points right there, and you might get the bonus. We will see.
Oh, man.
Nicole, how broke my chair.
Okay, can you play? Oh, can you play it again?
I suppose I can play it for you again.
Did you break the chair? Is that what you said?
No, we're okay now.
Here it is, Nicole.
Okay. Okay.
That is very accurate. 100 points for you as well.
Yeah, I think you got all the pictures too.
That was right on.
Yeah. You'd be surprised. I've been practicing that just for this moment. So.
I don't know if this is good or bad, but Bill Farmer might be in trouble. Mark, your turn.
Ah!
100 points for you too, Mark. I don't exactly know what that was, but
I don't know. I'm trying to find motivation. You know?
I'm gonna give Marco the extra 25 bonus points for breaking his chair.
Before we go any further, the hashtag for the giveaway while we're doing the
And let's tell them what we are gonna give away. Eclipse is doing a show. Is that correct?
We are, but that was, that's at a restaurant. I think it was the Tom Kubis Big Band.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Tom Kubis. That's right.
With the Swing Kittens. Yeah.
What's the date on this again? So we can make sure that our guests will be available to go.
Monday, the 26th.
This coming Monday, the 26th. If you are in Southern California and Long Beach and able to attend this show, we want you to go ahead and enter this hashtag because we're going to get you two tickets to the show, you and one more guest. So But you do have to be present and in California, Long Beach, to be able to win this. So one more time. There you go. And the hashtag will be up there for just a little bit. And remember, be present and available this Monday because we'll be buying you two tickets to go see the show. All righty.
All right.
Here we go.
Beautiful. All right. Yeah. We have a couple more. Mark, I think I'd like to see you go first with this one.
All right.
Just because, I don't know, this was the first one I thought of and I thought of seeing you do it. So okay. You're welcome. Here is your sound.
Thanks.
Oh my gosh.
You don't have to do the entire length.
It just keeps going, doesn't it?
Yeah. And that would be the Tasmanian devil spinning through the cartoons.
I miss Taz.
Oh, I do too. Oh, no. I think he's in a movie, though.
He's in a movie? What?
Did he go in Space Jam? Yeah.
Yeah.
Ooh, that's right. That's right.
Yeah. Okay. All right, Mark, have some fun.
Got to channel my inner Taz here. Mm-hmm.
Hundred points. That was
enough for a second.
Beautiful.
Oh my gosh.
Nicole.
Okay. Can you play a piece of it again? Not the whole thing.
I suppose I could. Let me reopen the right one. If it plays.
Been in my chair, but I can't. Okay.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know that. I got nothing.
Hey, you know what? 75 points for trying.
Thank you. Yes. Appreciate it.
Marco, you're up.
All right.
Oh,
this
no.
reminds me of some of the vocal warm-ups we do sometimes, right?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Let's see. Sorry.
Don't break the chair.
Too late.
Right? Hundred points there too. Mark gets the extra 25 for actually everything you did with that. That was crazy. All right, we have one more. This one might be the most iconic, and it might also age us. We will see.
Okay.
All right. Here is your sound. Anybody with AOL memories will remember dial-up internet.
Yep.
Whatever your best dial-up internet imitation is, who would like to go first?
I would like to get it over with.
Okay. Extra 50 points for volunteering.
Okay. Hold on. Oh, it's been so long. Okay. Could you do it one more? I'm sorry. One more. Just
you can do it. Yes, as many as you'd like.
Just one more. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Wait.
Don't give up. Keep going.
That's all I know. It's too much.
That 75 points right out the bat for going. Actually, it's 125 because you volunteered to go first. Plus, you did the guttural whatever thing was. So
yeah,
that's like 150 points. That's good.
Okay. Cool. Thank you.
Next, Marco.
Welcome. You've got mail.
Oh, 100 points. Very well played, including the You've Got Mail. Mark.
Uh oh.
Oh no.
Welcome to the internet.
Okay. So that's what the internet looks like as a robot, right? Is that what we saw? So was that a robot or was that the internet? I'm curious.
I thought it was, you know, my interpretive dance of the internet. Dialect.
I'll give you 50 points for it. Yay. I think that was more robot.
Okay.
I will admit this. Nicole stepped up every time. So she gets an extra 500 points. Wow. And she is our big winner tonight.
Yay.
Passing Mark's early lead.
You know, you never know what's going to happen in the game segment of the Fat Cat Swingers show. And
oh, man.
I love that every one of our guests have always been so so just
gracious.
Gracious and they go for it. And that's the fun thing we like about that here is that it just gives us a fun time to have a let loose and be different than we are on stage. You know what I mean?
So true.
That's right. And we love having blackmail for later, you know, just that's having true. Up on the internet forever.
Watch out.
You're welcome, Mark.
We got all the footage there. So thank you Mr. Dabbs for the game and the interpretation of the game.
Oh my gosh.
And you know, I think it's time we have are going to do our hashtag giveaway if
that's
we
right.
are able to.
Okay. Yeah, so Nicole, you can find your comment section, and if you haven't put in the hashtags, put them in now. Hurry up.
We'll have hurry, hurry. Put the hashtag in if you're in Long Beach, California. And yeah, we'll do a little giveaway there if you're available.
Yeah.
Let's see. Anna,
yeah.
Last name?
Palma.
Anna Palma. Congratulations.
Yay. Congratulations, Anna. Yes. Thank you so much. Anna's a big supporter. She's won a number of our prizes, actually.
Yeah.
I'm excited that she might get to go see your show. So
I'm excited to meet you. How fun.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Well, hey, and Nicole, I hope you had a good time on the show and, you know, letting loose with us here on season two.
I had the best time. I'm so glad I didn't have to do the movie game, though, because I was like, oh, I would be so bad at this. This was yeah, right up my alley. Believe it or not.
Yeah. Glad to hear awesome. It.
Cool. Well, we will make sure that we have some details posted for some other upcoming shows that you have, because you also have another show. There's a tribute show that's coming up, I think you said, on the 31st?
Yeah, the 31st. I'm singing with a Benny Goodman tribute show, and that's in Palos Verdes. And that's at 6 p.m., and that'll be really fun, featuring all of Benny Goodman's music. Done the Glenn Miller thing. Now I'm doing the Benny Goodman thing. So
why not?
Yeah, keep it going. So that's what's going on the 31st.
Wow. Yeah.
Cool.
So, friends, please give our friend Nicole and her groups. I think also we have the Eclipse Trio tag as well. If you guys can give a follow to and support, and you know, as we get out there, continue to help our music scene in Southern California and beyond continue to grow. So, once again, everybody, Nicole Kubis.
Thank you, guys.
Thanks so much, Nicole. Good to see you.
Good to see you guys too. Take care.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, that's the most throat workout I've had here, like trying voices and sounds. And oh everything.
Man, and you're a trooper. I know you were saying your voice was a little tired today, so yeah. thanks for jumping in.
I woke up with no voice this morning. I was like, what happened? I think I was just a little too tired from all the travel. But
yeah,
I'll tell you though, this show always brings me so much life. And I want to thank everybody out there who comes in and watches with us on Wednesday nights. If you could tell your friends, let them know about it. We're so, so close to that 1,000 subscriber mark. If you can help us do that. If you haven't already done so, please like and subscribe. And turn on those notifications so that you can join us on Wednesdays as we continue to bring you guests and just showcase the world of talent that we have all around us. So, gosh, I guess that's it, yeah?
That's it, yeah.
All right. We've made it to the end, everybody, and we'll see you next week. See you next Wednesday.
All right, bye.
It's time for us to say goodbye to all our friends. We hope you had a really great time. We'd love to stay some more and swing till the end of the night. the Van Gogh. We danced, we sang, we played our hearts out to you. We showed you what we're all about. We hope to see you again the next time we are around. That's when you tell your friends the fat cats are in town. Again, we'd like to thank someone. Oh wait, that someone would be you. Cause without you none of this would be true. Just remember to share that grimmick smile with somebody next to you. Cause your mind just brightens someone's cloudy day.